Hello, everyone. This is Jade Inspiration Masters. We are a communication leadership training institute based in the United States. We have several locations throughout the Dallas-Fort Worth area. Also, we have the programs for the executives, the business owners, and anyone who wants to enhance their communication and presentation skills. We also have the youth group program starting from the first grade all the way to 12th grade, along with the programs for the college students. As a part of our inspiring series, we get this great opportunity to meet the difference makers, the artists, the entrepreneurs, the business owners, the people who are making a difference, not just in the United States, but around the world. And today I have this great opportunity to meet here and welcome here Ms. Aarthi Diwan. Aarthi, welcome to Inspiration Masters.
Hi, Jay. Thank you for having me. It's a great honor to be on your, this platform and share my experience with you.
Yeah, we've been longing to invite you for a long time. So we are here. So I'm glad to have you here. And I'll give you a brief introduction. All my friends here. Aarthi has completed her teaching, Texas teaching certification through SMU, has spent several years in teaching in private and public school. And she is, along with being a mother, a teacher, she is also the director for the Gideon Math and Reading in Frisco and McKinney. And she is an entrepreneur who is handling both of these centers. So we are going to find out a whole lot from Aarthi today about the math and reading and along with all the programs and what is going on currently. So welcome, Aarthi. And I'm going to come to you and find out. I want you to introduce yourself to the audience and also tell us about how you got started and how you ended up getting the math and reading classes started.
Sure. Jay, it started a long time back. I got my teaching certification from SMU in 2006. And when my kids were younger, I kind of went back and forth from teaching and being a teacher and also being a mom. So kind of, worked in public schools for a bit and then also worked at private schools and did some private tutoring to kind of manage and juggle the mom and the teacher role initially. And I was teaching at a private school and my daughter was younger and I was looking for a program for her to also kind of, have that structure and get stronger and build a strong foundation. And that's when I came across with Gideon. Of course, as a mother and as a teacher, I researched a lot and I really liked their step-by-step, program and their structure, how they conducted their curriculum. When I decided to quit my full-time job and do something else, I think Gideon was such was an option that I kind of looked into and start my own, center in Frisco. Frisco didn't really have a center at that time. So I brought that center. I started my center in 2014 in Frisco. And I got excellent, build really great friendships and relationship with my parents. I have parents who've been with me since then. And there came an opportunity in 2018 to have another center as the lady who ran the center in McKinney was retiring. So I kind of took over that center as well. So now I have two locations. One is in Frisco off of Preston and Stonebrook and one is in McKinney, which is right off 121 Custer. Mm-hmm. So, been managing those two locations and also working with a lot of kids. So it kind of gives me a nice balance between doing my passion, which is teaching, at the same time, juggle my biggest role as a mom as well.
Right. And I can attest to that amazing program of Gideon, because my son went to Gideon with Wendy Coppedge in Coppell at the Coppell location.
Yes.
So we're very familiar with the program and it's very interesting. And I'm glad you took that over. So because that becomes a very helpful thing for the community. People can walk to the closest place where they can find in.
Right.
So of course, we are going to go into much detail on the program part two, but tell us something about the summer slide to COVID slide. We know that it's very unusual this time and it's sad at the same time, a whole lot of things going on. Kids are at home. So tell us something about that. How did this extended slide go on, and what is it?
So usually, like, you know, when we usually in a regular year, like, you know, we do see a lot of what we call a summer slide, because a lot of kids, you know, usually will take that 3 month off from June, July, August. And, you know, so-called break from learning is what, you know, a lot of them take.
Right.
And, but when the kids do come in September, we do see, like, you know, that's called the summer slide.
Right.
This year, that summer slide has kind of got extended, and now we're calling it a COVID slide because kids have been off school since March.
A long time, yeah.
So, you know, we of course had virtual school. You know, schools did an excellent job trying to kind of, you know, switch over to virtual academy. But at the same time, you know, a lot of parents have seen that. You know, there was a huge gap that was kind of created with that. So, you know, that's why we're calling it a COVID slide now.
Yeah.
So we are trying to kind of, you know, make sure our kids don't have these permanent gaps. We're trying to make sure, like, you know, these gaps are filled. That way there's no holes in the foundation, and they are, they're strong leaders. You know, they end up being strong leaders, and like your program definitely helps with that as well. And at the same time, like, you know, they have daily practice to make sure they are building that strong foundation with their mastered their math and reading and other concepts. And at the same time, build their confidence, because that's really what we are going for. We're building their confidence. And because we don't want them to struggle at school. We want them to be strong. We want them to stay ahead of the grade level, not be catching up.
Yeah, I mean, those gaps have to be covered. And we do on the communication side. So it's the same thing. Like, it's, you have to get them constantly engaged.
Right.
And those slides are not really good. And these things, we don't know the end. It might be coming soon or later, but we are working on that. So that's the part.
Yes.
And there are changes we had to make. So how do you thrive in the new normal? What are the changes you had to make?
So again, like, you know, when all this happened, just, you know, same thing with Gideon also, like, you know, we switched our, you know, of course we had to be shut down. So we had to switch off our in-person face-to-face classes to virtual. So we also are doing virtual. So right now, since we have been open, we still have many students doing Gideon virtually. They still get books because, you know, I feel like when kids do write stuff, they learn better because, you know, the connection that the brain makes with, you know, hand, they end up learning and retaining stuff better. Yeah. So kids are still getting their books. We are doing classes just as regular, twice a week with them virtually.
Mm-hmm.
We have some kids who are coming to the center as well. So of course we're taking all the precautions that as recommended, you know, masks and the social distancing and all that stuff we are doing.
Absolutely.
So far I feel like, you know, we have done a great job making sure everybody stays safe, because that's the most important part.
The safety is a major concern for all the parents, and that's the main thing. And you have established something which is called a pod. Can you explain that concept of a pod so that way everybody is assured that it's all safe and everything?
Yes. So what you know, when all this happened, and especially, like, you know, when we saw initially, we all thought it's going to be for a couple of months, right? But now, you know, we don't know when it's going to end, which is unfortunate, but my biggest concern was all my young learners, my little bitty elementary kids, you know, because for them, that's the hardest, you know, for them, you know, they are still starting out. We want to make sure, like I said, have a strong foundation. And that's where, you know, with working parents, it's very hard for them to juggle their work at the same time, manage these kids at home. And, you know, they're not ready to go back to school because, like I said, it's not really safe for them to go back to school as well. So what we created was something called a learning pod, or a pandemic pod that you can call it. So what I have is it's a very small group. It's a very small group of six kids that come in from 7:30 till 3. Parents drop off. So we are, everybody has their own kind of setup. They're socially distanced. They have their own space. They have their, you know, books. So we at Gideon, our teachers and us are, and me, and helping them facilitate, you know, their virtual school, what the school is requiring them, what their schedule is from school. But at the same time, you know, if they need any assistance with the asynchronous stuff, if they have any homework or any kind of help that they need, because these kids don't have typing skills. Most of them, they're not reading at the level that, you know, they require for these stuff. So they need an adult to help them run their virtual school.
Mm-hmm.
So we are doing that because, of course, you know, parents need help too. But at the same time, we created such a small bubble that way, like, you know, it's not like you're going back to the big school.
Mm-hmm.
You're just coming in. And all these parents who kind of committed to this are, you know, have a same sort of mindset also. They're being safe. They are being conscious, and they are trying to kind of, you know, keep that bubble small. That way our kids stay safe.
So we help them with
making sure they have no issues with technology. They are focused during the school. Mm-hmm. They're meeting their grade level benchmarks as well, because like you said, you know, with the COVID slide, a lot of gaps been created. So we are making sure they are meeting their school expectations, but at the same time, if there are any additional gaps that they need to be filled, we are making sure we are taking it a notch up and helping them, you know, build that foundation as well.
That's so true.
Gaps. Yeah,
absolutely true, because the gaps are not very helpful, and considering the time which has passed, so that is really very important. And tell us something more about, because you've been in education for a long time and in schools as well as running these two centers,
mm-hmm.
about the foundation part, about having the impact of the weak foundation in math and reading, and how do you solve that part, and also something on the part of tips for the advice or for the tips for the parents who are juggling all these things together at this time.
So, I mean, you know, foundation is really important. Like, just like, you know, if you're building a house, you will not build a house on a weak foundation. So same thing goes with math and reading, or like, you know, anything like, and that sort of starts ground up. So it doesn't have to be like where you grill your child at the same time, but at the same time, like, it's kind of like, you know, a little bit of practice will really help them in the long run. So it's kind of like you going to the gym, or you're learning how to play piano. You know, you don't go to gym just once a month, and you know, you don't expect to have six pack abs for just going once a month, right? You kind of have to do at least 4 to 5 days a week.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, kind of going with a similar analogy, kind of having it daily practice, about 20, 30 minutes of practice every day will really help them kind of go a long run. So one of the biggest tips I always tell parents is just have a little bit of practice every day, have a routine, have a structure of doing something every day, be it reading books for 10 minutes every day before going to bedtime.
Right.
You know, things like that will definitely help kids build a stronger foundation, yes. Build a love for learning,
mm-hmm.
And also kind of enjoy what they're doing, because then, you know,
absolutely.
Be confident as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, and our program really helps with that, because the homework and everything that the Gideon provides, and you can talk from your personal experience, from your child, daily practice really goes a long way.
Yeah absolutely.
So, you know, having that routine, having that structure, having positive reinforcement, because, you know, a lot of times, you know, we want our child to keep moving forward.
Yeah.
But at the same time, like I said, reward the effort. If they're putting the effort,
mm-hmm.
even if they do slight improvement, even they grow a little bit, you know, just have that positive reinforcement and encourage them to do better.
That is so true. So we,
especially in these times when there's so much of negativity around, we have to really, be a good role model for our own kids and have absolutely. That positive attitude towards everything. Yeah.
So we do promote that same thing with the communication part. We do promote that part, that whatever you are showing up when you are on the court, it's because of the homework you do at home.
That's right.
The most important part. You're not going to be showing up great when you are on the court throwing that ball in the basket. It's not going to go in the basket if you've not practiced enough.
That's right. Practice makes, I don't call them perfect, but practice makes you better. Like, you
makes
know,
you
nobody's
better.
Perfect,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it doesn't make
sense. And it's a teamwork. Better. Like, you know, like you said, you know, I can do my part.
Yeah.
You know, the parents can, you know, I always tell the kids, like, you are the quarterback. You know, your parents
absolutely.
Can show up, can bring uh-huh. you to class. They can pay for this.
Uh-huh.
They can encourage you, but you have to do the job.
Ultimately,
I can do my job. So it's a whole team that we all have to work together.
Absolutely. Yeah. And so tell us something more about the benefits of the program other than math and reading. I think you have some more advantages.
So like I already emphasized, like, you know, of course you learn the real math and reading concept part of it. But what it really teaches is the discipline, the responsibility of doing my homework every day, like, mm-hmm. you know, of showing up. And, you know, we teach, of course, we focus a lot on handwriting and writing and grammar and all the other stuff as well. But I think the soft skills that you learn, I think are really important. I've always tell the parents is like, you know, reward the effort, you know, the effort the child puts in. And a lot of times kids don't pass the book, like, you know, because they have daily, they have weekly assessments. Like, you know, if they don't pass the book, it's okay. We tried, you know, and next time we're going to try better. Even we might not get through even the second time, at least did we improve from the last time or not? That's so again, you know, having that, you know, a calendar of events to do, or like like a timetable, like how are we going to do this? Those kind of responsibility and, you know, structure that this program provides, I feel the kids really need that, especially in this age that we are currently, you know, living
right now. I think that's the major differentiating point of Gideon, how it works on every single time.
And yeah, and it's a step-by-step program. So, you know, it's not attached to any grade level. It's based on where the child is. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it provides a great tool if the child is looking for enrichment, because they have no stopping. They can keep moving forward. But if they're struggling at the same time and they have some catch up to do, they have to fill in the gaps, they can fill in those gaps and, you know, meet the grade level benchmarks. Right. In the long run, my goal is to keep the kids a little bit ahead of grade level. Uh-huh. That way they are, school is easy, they are confident, and they enjoy what they're doing. So that's always the goal in the long run.
That is so true, yeah, because it's just standing still, you still get falling behind. So you always have to go ahead, even if you stand still, you just, because the world is moving around you, you fall behind. So that was very interesting information about the program and how you are helping everyone around there. So again, everyone, it's Frisco and McKinney. There are two centers of Gideon. You can contact Ms. Arthi. And if you can tell us one more time about both the locations as well as how can people reach you?
Sure. Our locations, if you can search up, it's Gideon Math and Reading Frisco's. The Frisco one is right off of Preston and Stonebrook. The McKinney one is right at the corner of Plano, Allen, Frisco, and McKinney, because it's right on 121 and Custer. So you can search up us on website. You can read our reviews. You can, of course, call me. My phone number is 469-305-7107. I guess Jay can share that as well.
He'll put it up, all that information.
Yeah, I mean, you can, of course, find us on Facebook. And, you know, like I said, our website is a great resource. Our website is a great resource. In fact, Gideon has a whole Gideon Learning YouTube where you can actually, all our books have YouTube videos also that go with it.
Oh, that's great.
And I tell my kids, they're not the fun YouTube videos that you watch, but it's like learning videos that they can see. Like, you know,
learn along with fun, yeah.
Yeah, so it really helps the kids, you know, because there are explanations in the books as well. But at the same time, you know, when they listen and, you know, through videos, it helps them too. Right. So, you know, they can, parents can always subscribe to that. There are a lot of free, you know, tips and everything on our Gideon website too. So that's something that parents can, you know, definitely take advantage of.
There are several ways to connect. So everyone watching today, thank you so much. Thank you, Arthi, for this amazing information today.
Thank you, Jay, for having me again. Yeah.
And everyone, thanks for watching. Again, Arthi, thank you so much on behalf of the entire team of Inspiration Masters. We wish you all the best with all the things you undertake.
And
again, everyone, thanks for watching. This is Jay at Inspiration Masters. Do not forget to subscribe on the YouTube channel and hit the bell button so you do not miss any of the episodes and you get notified when one of these videos come through. Also, like us on Facebook so you do not miss again any of the interviews which are coming up and the great information which is constantly flowing through the Inspiring team. Again, this is Jay. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you back in a week.